And so, as we think about that, we ask, you know, how do we keep this spirit alive? I think it's the way we do that is by realizing that we celebrate as Christians the entire Christian year. It's not a culmination that happens at Christmas and then it's all over. That's the way it is maybe in the secular world, but in the Christian year, it's a continuous cycle. And Christmas is not the end of that cycle, it's really just the beginning. I don't know if you realize that or not, but Advent is the beginning of the calendar year. So we are beginning, Advent began year B. There's a three-year cycle in the Christian calendar. And in that three-year cycle, you have basically two seasons that are everything is broken down into. That is Christmas and Easter. Christmas being the beginning. And so Christmas, you have Advent and Christmas and Epiphany. And then, of course, after that you have Easter, which is Lent, Easter, and Pentecost. And we continue to celebrate in the church these things. With each cycle, there are colors, you may notice. These should actually be white, but in the Christian calendar, the colors change with the season. So you will have a season of what's called a preparatory season that's purple usually. And the purple is a time of preparing, Lent and those times. And then the festival season, Christmas and the other times that we're actually celebrating, is white usually. And then it's always followed by the color green, which is a season of growth. It's called ordinary time. So after each cycle, there's a season that's called ordinary time that's really a color known as green. It signifies growth and the idea that we are growing as we're entering into these seasons. And so you have these continuous cycles, and you have some special little days stuck in there, like you might use red on Pentecost and those things. But each of these cycles are, as we think of a cycle, it's like a circle. It doesn't end. And so for the Christian life, I don't know if you ever thought about it like that, but we are continuing the celebration, and we're just beginning the Christian year right now. And we're looking forward to Lent and for Easter, which is one of the climaxes of the Christian year, of course, has to be. And then it just continues. And it's a three-year cycle that we continue. I think it's, to me, it's great because it keeps us, what it does is it focuses, we do the lectionary readings, it focuses on the life of Christ. And so when they came to see Jesus, the baby, in that day on that first Christmas, they didn't say, well, it's all over now. Christmas is over. No, that was just the beginning. Jesus would live a life in front of people, and he would heal the people that were blind. He would do great things. He would walk on the water, and he would die. But then he was raised from the dead, and he ascended into heaven. And so that was just the beginning of that wonderful Christian year.